All right, so looks like I died. I'm gonna go pick up my souls and then see if we can't get to the boss this round. Okay, I'm gonna pull this lever and that ship will come over. That's the ship I need. Oh crap. Unlock this shortcut here and die. Perfect. So luckily I got the shortcut. I'm sorry, I haven't really been talking a whole lot this episode. It's fine. I'm like not actually good at talking too much, so honestly, I'm just trying to catch up as quickly as I can to where we were in the previous playthrough. It just kind of happened that this game, we're making some real strides here quite early on. What's wrong? Gross. I've ever gotten that item before. I wonder what it is. Well, I gotta get it, because otherwise it's gonna drive me crazy. It's a good item. Maybe later on I'll come. So this is Lucatiel. I'm gonna summon her for this fight. Later on, I'll kind of get that weapon that I was telling you guys about in last episode. But right now, I don't want to have to deal with all those trash pandas. So, Lucatiel, come on. She's just getting destroyed over there. I actually talked to Danny about naming a child Lucatiel, and she said okay. Holy crap. Luca. Cool. Bringing all the people up here. I'm gonna buff my weapon with some aromatic ooze, giving it some magic damage. And then let's see if we can't just destroy this guy. This boss fight is actually pretty cool because if you don't beat it fast enough, you start losing your ability to walk because the water will rise up. Okay, awesome. We killed that boss way fast. Thank you for distracting the boss, Luca. Goodbye. Let's get out of here. So up here, there's going to be an item that was really good in Dark Souls 1, but in Dark Souls 2, it takes so much time to level up that I don't know if it's worth it. And that is the Pyromancy Flame. Basically, that's just the item that gives you Pyromancer abilities. If you do level it up, I've seen people do really good builds with the Pyromancer Flame, but that's not my favorite. Especially, well, I like it, but you have to find fire seeds. And the fire seeds are either really expensive or you have to find them in the weirdest locations to actually upgrade your pyromancy glove. So, alright. This is, if you notice, the eagle dropped us at the tower of the Lost Bastille, and this is dropping us here at the ocean. Yeah, so there's that. This reminds me of the Hobbit, when there's like the drunk elves or whatever, and they escape. Anyway, it's silly, but that's what it reminds me of. Looks like my weapon is losing some of its juice. If that little bar in the bottom goes all the way down, I lose durability, and so I don't want to do that because then your item breaks. If you notice, there was a item down below us. That is just a sword item. I'm trying to remember what they call it. Like a scimitar or something? No, that's not what it's called. Anyway, I don't really want it. I'm not gonna go get it. Although, it probably would make good content. We got some good souls now. Let's travel back to Majula and level up our item, our weapon. This next boss is gonna be... if I decide to do this next boss, I might just use a different weapon anyway. We'll see. Large titanite shard. Awesome.
I'll be around if you make it back.
Okay, let's see. I need some big strength here. I'm just gonna level up strength, and then we're gonna spend the rest of our souls on life gems. Because life gems is life. Let's go here. I'm gonna go unlock the next blacksmith, and then I will probably stop the video there. So I need to go kill these wolves first before I go for this item. And he didn't die, so come here, my friend. Taste my mace. And get stuck in the wall. Weirdo. Okay, so the pursuer is actually gonna continuously respawn in areas now. And this guy, he's a little bit more powerful. You can see his red eyes. I just needed that item for this next area, so if I kill him, I get a really good weapon, actually. Or not a weapon, but I get an item that helps me upgrade my next weapon. That's alright. I will. I don't know. Maybe I'll do it next time. Maybe I'll do it next time. This guy is called. Technically, he's called a pyromancer, but I call him trash. Ah, Lucatiel, my friend. I think you need to summon her for like 3 battles. And then her quest line continues.
I thought that might be you. The longer I am here, the more madness I discover. A wretched place indeed, but not without traces of its former glory. What could have caused such degradation?
Ugh, her voice is so haunting. Really hoping that guy wouldn't see me this soon. Halberd. Halberds are a combination of axes and spears with the, dang it. He really is trash. Okay, let's go unlock. Luckily that went off without a hitch. Usually I kind of stink that up and I end up not blowing up that barrel. Right. Minutes of torch left. That's just fine. Because I just need to light that. I'm not sure what the dull ember is all about, but basically it gets him to help you out here. And I can infuse my weapons now. I have a magic stone that I got from the crow area. And I'll have to go back there just to show you guys what that's all about. I'm not gonna do a magic build, so I don't know if I wanna infuse that. But I am gonna infuse this one more time. And then I'm gonna take all his items. I didn't want to talk to you, but since I'm talking to you, I will.
Hold on, Bobby.
Be gone. Thank you.
Be gone.
That was an item I don't care to have. And one more treasure chest is the one he's sitting on, so I'm gonna sit here, let him respawn at his bench. And this is probably gonna be my next weapon, depending on how powerful it is. The Craftsman Hammer. Let's see how it compares. Apparently I can't wield this weapon either. Let's level it up once and see. So it does 199. Yeah, I guess that's okay. I don't know, let's see. Yeah, it's pretty decent. I might use it to go kill a pursuer. Alright, you guys, thanks for watching. I will see you guys in the next video.